Hello! In this video, we'll show you how to configure RSA Secure ID as multi-factor authentication in PowerProtect Data Domain for local users. In this demo, we are using DDoS 7.10. Upload the RSA server certificate into the data domain under the path DDR/var/certificates. Note that the license should be in .pem format. Here, the certificate, which is located in the /temp folder on a Linux server, has already been created and converted into .pem format. Use the scp command to copy the certificate into data domain. Enter the password for a successful connection and copy the file into data domain. Now, navigate to the data domain CLI to import the copied certificate using this import command. The certificate for the application RSA Secure ID has now been imported successfully. Enter the command authentication MFA RSA-Secure ID client show. The command output provides details, including the server URL, client ID, serial number, and so on. Here, the output shows only the serial number of the DD. Note that the remaining details are empty. In the next few steps, we will configure these details. If a passphrase is not already set for the DD, add one using the system passphrase set command. Before we enable MFA for the DD, we must add an MFA troubleshooter user using this user add command. In the data domain CLI, log in as a security user to enable the authorization policy for the security officer. We are now done with all the prerequisites. In our system admin CLI session, we execute the authentication client set command to configure the RSA server's URL and client ID. In this instance, launchpad.demo.local is the place where the RSA Secure Token ID app is installed, and rsa.demo.local is the RSA server. Port number 5555 is used by default and can be changed based on the requirement, but it needs to be updated in the RSA console as well. To get the client key, navigate to the RSA console and select Setup, System Settings, RSA Secure ID Authentication API. Now we use the client show command again to see that all the details that we entered are updated. Run the command to enable the MFA for RSA Secure ID. This will prompt us to enter SEC officer credentials, followed by sysadmin credentials. The status command displays the information about the login options and its value. Now, navigate to the RSA Secure ID UI and under Home, select Manage Users. Click Add New to add the user sysadmin in RSA. Enter a user ID in the format username@serial-number. Enter the password, keep everything else as default, and click Save. Now that the user has been created, let's create software token profiles. Navigate to Authentication, Software Token Profiles, and click Manage Existing. Let's create a new profile by clicking Add New. We enter the profile name and select the device type of our choice. Here we are selecting Desktop PC 4.0. You can select a token code duration and a token code length as needed. Because this is a demo video, we select No PIN Required for the authentication type and select the file-based delivery method. Open the RSA Secure ID Token app, select Options, then Token Storage Devices. Copy the device type info. This value should match the default value. If not, update it. In this demo, the values are the same, so we simply click Save to create the software token profiles. To assign the Secure ID tokens, navigate to Authentication Secure ID Tokens, and then Manage Existing. Select the Unassigned tab to view the list of tokens that are available. Select one and click Go to display the Users tab. Select the user that we created a couple of steps earlier and click Assign. The token has been assigned to the sysadmin user. Select the serial number and click Distribute. From the dropdown, select the token profile that we created. Select No Password and click Save and Distribute. The token has now been issued. Download the token and unzip it. Open the RSA Secure ID, select Options, Import Token, then select Import from File. Upload the downloaded token file and click OK. We can change the token name for easier identification. Now, test the passcode using this authentication command. When we copy and paste the passcode from the RSA Secure ID app, we see that it verified successfully. Now, let's log in to DD System Manager using the sysadmin credential, which will prompt us to enter a passcode. Using it, we are able to log in successfully. Navigate to Administration and then Access. Expand the multi-factor authentication to check all the details that we have configured so far. Execute the following disable command, which will prompt for security officer credentials and then sysadmin credentials. It also prompts for a passcode to disable MFA. Now, when we try to log in to DD System Manager as sysadmin, it no longer prompts us for a passcode. This concludes the demo. Thanks for watching.